Welcome, everybody, to God on a New Level. We are excited that you are here today, and we, Brenda, and
yes.
us together, are here to take you to a whole new level.
Oh, we're thank ready. We're ready.
Thank you for joining us. Listen, Brenda, you've got an incredible event happening that I want you to tell the world.
This next coming weekend is my women's conference, Woman, You Are Anointed, all day Saturday. We're going to preach. We're going to minister in the Holy Spirit. I'll be ministering. My special guest, though, will be with me, who's Joni Lamb from Daystar, along with all the Daystar singers. They're going to come and minister to us in the Spirit. The conference is completely free. It starts at 10 o'clock in the morning. I think we have a little breakfast at 9 or 9:30. You can get on at hankabrenda.org, get all of the details. But you need to be here. It's still not too late to make plans to come, and we're thrilled. And then Sunday, Marcus Lamb is going to be at Lord of Hosts Church.
He's a powerful preacher, too.
Yes, he is. As our special guest, he's going to be preaching for us, so you could stay over on Sunday.
Yeah, we'd love to have him.
Enjoy church with us. So make sure you come on out this coming weekend, April the 21st, and then Sunday the 22nd. Yeah. We want you to be our special guest.
And I want you to tell Joni to sing that song that when we are on Daystar,
they sing a song called Adonai. I'm sure we'll
push it. You can join us for that, too, and maybe they might let me sing with the Daystar singers.
I don't know about that.
I don't think that'll happen, but miracles do happen. You know,
yeah,
I can't sing,
do.
And they don't know that about me. I can't sing.
And I don't know.
I do
maybe he'll be a silent honorary member or something like that.
God likes it if I sing, right? He likes it if we all sing. He likes it if you sing. I'm so honored you're here. We have another program that we want to talk about. We were talking about kingdom blessings in the past weeks, but today we're going to talk about, in light of all of that, how to be blessed in the kingdom.
Yes.
And Brenda, it's the principle of a seed.
Yes.
There's power in a seed.
Yes.
So I want you to open
Jesus
your Bibles
said the
if
whole
you can.
Kingdom is based on it.
You know, wherever you're at, maybe if you don't have a Bible, then I'll just go ahead and quote it to you. But if you have a Bible, it's really important that you write in it. In fact, I was just thinking, Brenda, I was on an airplane, and there was a couple ladies, one sitting on one side of me, I was sitting in the middle. I had that wonderful favorite seat that everybody likes. You're the center of attention, the center seat.
Yeah.
Not. Nobody likes that center
seat. No, they don't. I always get
when we
fly together.
I don't want anybody sitting next to me except you. But anyway, so I'm sitting there, and this one lady, I'm reading my Bible, and the one lady on my right, she looks at me, she says, man, I tell you what, you might be watching even if you are. Good to see you. And she says, wow, look at your Bible. You've really written in it. The other one said, you know, that Bible has a lot of notes in it. How long did it take you to do that? And I said, well, I've been serving God many years, and it's important to know your Bible. So I want to encourage you, grab your Bible. But Genesis chapter 8.
Yes.
And we're going to look at that
powerful
today.
Powerful verse. I know
it says in verse 22,
yep.
While the earth remains. All right, this isn't a trick question. Is the earth here?
Yeah, it is.
Okay. People are always trying to judge it and blow it up, but it's here. God's not going to let it go anywhere. But as long as the earth remains, there is seed, now watch this, time and harvest. Now, the Bible says seed, time, and harvest, but I'm going to tell you seed / time and harvest. In other words, it's a process. Mm-hmm. And I think that's sometimes where people miss it in the power of a seed. Mm-hmm. They think if they put a seed in the ground that is going to happen overnight,
right,
that something's going to happen. And the thing that we have to remember is when you plant a natural seed in the soil, you may not be able to see what's going on underneath the soil, but something is. It's germinating. It's getting ready to produce.
Yep.
And eventually, it springs forth underneath the soil to where you begin to see it.
Right.
That's the same way it is when we sow into the kingdom, when we pray.
Mm-hmm.
Something begins to take place underneath the soil or in the spirit.
Yep.
Then all of a sudden, it springs forth and it begins to manifest in this realm. And we see all along that the process was working or is working.
Yep.
Now, have you ever thought about this for a minute? Brent, I was reading. Jesus said in Mark chapter 4, and I share that with previous programs. In fact, you can go out there and look at our previous programs, the archives, and you can see some of the previous programs we talked about kingdom blessing.
Good stuff. Good stuff.
But Jesus said the kingdom is built on a seed. Okay? And then in one verse, he said, how are we going to make a comparison to the kingdom? He said it's like a person who sows seed into the ground.
Right.
So we have to understand the kingdom laws work. The kingdom principles will work every time. We just got to know how to appropriate them. As long as the earth remains, there will be seed, time, and harvest. It's a process. Now, I never thought of this, Brenda. Jesus said these words. He said, unless you become like a child, you cannot inherit the kingdom. Mm-hmm. Do you know that is true? Mm-hmm. You cannot inherit kingdom blessings unless you become like a child. Now, oftentimes we think that's only talking about the simplicity of a child.
Right.
Okay,
right.
Or a certain simplistic faith of
yes.
a child.
Yeah.
But I think it's more than that.
Yeah.
It's Jesus saying it's a process. Unless you come into the kingdom.
Start out of babyhood.
A new birth.
Yeah.
Born again. Unless you start off and are willing to work the process.
Right.
You'll never enter into the full
it's
benefits
the
of the kingdom.
It's the growth process.
Jesus said this. He said about the kingdom. He said the kingdom is like a pearl. Now, why did he compare it to a pearl? I did research.
Share with us what
this is.
I know
this
what. Well,
deep.
I know what you're going to say
because she's heard my notes.
It's good though.
But this is deep. Okay.
This is good.
I found out that it takes years. It's a process to produce or make a pearl. It starts off with a piece of sand in a clam,
which isn't very precious.
I hate clams.
I know.
I don't like any seafood. Somebody asked me once, "What's your favorite fish?" I said, "Easy, fish sticks." And so anyway,
I don't know if those are count.
Yeah, but you're helping me. But you know, how does a pearl form? It forms off of the sand over time. It begins, and I looked, and it said it could take up to 20 years.
Wow.
Until it becomes that precious pearl.
No wonder those are
what
so
about the kingdom? Unless you become like a child and grow and mature, you'll never experience the full benefits of God's kingdom.
Wow.
So how do you appropriate this? Well, let me say this. The first thing you have to do is you have to be willing to seek first that kingdom. That's the first decision. In other words, make a decision in your life that you're going to put God first and put His ways of doing things first.
Right.
And then I want to encourage you, start sowing or planting seeds.
Yep.
Not just financial ones, but plant seeds of love.
Well, now don't you think it's the effort you put into something.
That's right.
You know, just like a
Jesus
farmer.
Said that measure that you.
If a farmer plants and waters and fertilizes that seed, it's going to grow so that he gets optimum yield.
Right.
And so the amount that you put into kingdom things, kingdom effort, if you sow into the kingdom and you take the time to put heart and your mind in the Word of God and you speak over that seed and you prophesy to that seed and, you know, it might look today like nothing's happening. I'm sure to the farmer there's a couple months in there. It doesn't look like anything's going on. You know what I'm saying? But eventually something is going to come up and produce. And so you've got to stay with it. And Jesus said, you know, you said in another program that if you give or you sow, it shall be. It's a law.
It's
so
a law.
If you stay with this, the law will work. It's a working kingdom. The effort you put in, you're going to get out
Why
of it.
Why do you think Jesus said it's better? These are the words of Jesus. I think it's Acts 20. It's better to give than to receive. Now, most of us, it's better to receive. I know with me, I'd rather receive. But really, it's better to give. Why? Because you're limited if you're only on the receiving end.
Right.
But when you give, there's no limit.
There's seeds
it's
going
just
in.
Limited to how much you give. You just keep giving and giving and giving and giving and giving and giving, and you will reap.
That's awesome.
And you will receive. That's why it's better to sow.
It will work.
Let's pray for these precious people today around the world.
Brenda, hallelujah.
You're anointed.
Let's go for it.
Go for it. Let's
stretch your hands with
them.
Us to the screen today. Right now,
you,
in Jesus' name, I stretch my hands to you. I know you're out there and you've got some seeds in the ground and you're saying, God, I haven't seen a harvest yet. Right now, I come in agreement for your harvest, and I believe in the name of Jesus that the seeds of love you've sown, the seeds of good that you've sown, the financial seeds that you've sown, the seeds that you've sown with the words of your mouth are coming to pass and they're working. And so I prophesy to your life and I command those seeds to produce to a bountiful and full harvest. And I decree that in Jesus' name, your kingdom blessings are come and they're upon you right now. I speak to the one that's hurting. I speak to those that have been through challenges. If you've been through a challenge, I want you to take this by faith today and see your harvest in your own eyes. See it coming to pass. And I decree in the name of Jesus that it's upon you right now. I command a tangible anointing to be upon you. Let it come down over your head from the top of your head to the sole of your feet. In fact, I believe you're feeling the touch of God right where you're seated. It's manifesting on your life, and I know you're going to be blessed. We're Hank and Brenda. It's been a thrill to be with you once again, going to a new level.